Hello everyone, welcome to my channel which is Learning Institute, and today I am going to discuss about the nuclear physics, the basic properties of the nuclear physics. So let's start the video. So first of all, introduction. So on the basis of alpha ray scattering experiment, Rutherford described that the atom, inside the atom there is a very small nucleus in which all positive charge and most of the mass is localized. This is all the positive charge localized in the small nucleus in the central part. In this video we will study about the nuclear charge, nuclear mass, size, shape, binding energy, angular momentum, magnetic moment, statistics and the parity. So structure of nuclei. So we are all known that there are two types of particles called as the nucleons. First is proton, it has positive charge, and neutron, it has neutral. Atomic number, the number of proton inside the nucleus is called the atomic number, it is represented by Z. Mass number, it is the total number of nucleons, that is proton plus neutron, it is represented by A, and this is equal to Z plus N. Now the symbolic representation of the nucleus is Zx to the power A, or you can write as, for example, oxygen 16 and helium. So these are the examples of symbolic representation of nucleus. Now isotopes. So nuclei with the same atomic number Z but different mass number A are called the isotopes. For example, 1H1, 1S2, 1S3 are isotopes of hydrogen. Now isobar, nuclei with same mass number but different atomic number Z are called the isobars. For example, oxygen 16 and nitrogen 16. So these have the same mass number 16 and 16 but the different atomic number 8 and the 7. Now isotones. So nuclei with same mass number of neutron are called the isotones. For example, nitrogen 14 and carbon 13 are the isotones because these have the same number of neutron. Now mirror nuclei. Mirror nuclei, a pair of isobaric nuclei are known as the mirror nuclei, where in the nucleus the proton number Z and the electron and the neutron number N are interchanged and differ by one unit is called the mirror nuclei. So this is the differ by one unit. So here is the neutron number is 5, here proton number is 5, here neutron number is 6, here proton number is 6. So these are differ by one unit and proton and neutron number are interchanged. So these nuclei are known as the mirror nuclei. Now the very important topic is the binding energy of the nucleus. Inside the nucleus, protons and neutrons are strongly bound. So to separate nucleons from each other we need few MeV energy, which is called the binding energy of the nucleus. But the question arises, what is the source of this energy? Why should be this energy? So according to mass energy equivalence, special relativity, the energy equivalent corresponding to complete conversion of mass into energy is mc square, where c is the speed of light in free space. In forming a nucleus out of a constituent particles, a fraction of total mass constituent disappears and produce energy equal to Eb. क्लियर. तो सम पार्ट जो है वो डिसअपियर हो जाता है फॉर्मेशन के दौरान, वही पार्ट हमें बाइंडिंग एनर्जी देता है. सो दिस इज द सोर्स ऑफ बाइंडिंग एनर्जी, दैट इज अ मास डिफेक्ट. सो मास डिफेक्ट इज द सोर्स ऑफ बाइंडिंग एनर्जी. नाउ आई विल डिस्कस द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर बाइंडिंग एनर्जी. सो सपोज इफ डेल्टा एम बी द अमाउंट ऑफ मास डिसअपियर, then the energy, binding energy equal to delta m into c square. If m, mp, mn and mt be the masses of proton, neutron and electron respectively, then we can calculate the mass defect as delta m equal to z multiplied by mass of proton plus number of neutron into mass of neutron plus z, that is the number of proton equal number of electron multiplied by mass of electron minus atom, mass of the atom. So here m is the mass of atom. Now this mass is nothing but the mass of nucleus plus mass of electron. So we can put here m of fz is equal to minus this and this, and finally we get the expression for binding energy as eb equal to z of mp plus nmn minus mass of nucleus into c square, where m of nuc is the mass of the nucleus. So this is the very important expression for the binding energy. Now the binding fraction curve. Binding fraction FB is the ratio of binding energy to mass number. So this is the ratio of binding energy to the mass number, and this is also called the binding energy per nucleon. So this is the plot of binding energy per nucleon versus nucleon number. So this is the nucleon number and this is binding energy per nucleon. So graph is showing here the helium, oxygen. So initially it is increasing for helium and oxygen, and then reaches the highest for iron, and then slowly decreases for the heavy nuclei. So the from the observation from the graph is, so the first observation is FB is very small for very light nuclei and goes on increasing rapidly with increasing A. This is showing for a small nuclei, this is binding energy is very low for hydrogen, this is very low for lithium, but jaise jaise hum mass number ko increase kar rahe hain waise waise binding energy badh rahi hai MAB mein. And goes on increasing rapidly with A and reaches a maximum value 8 million electron volt per nucleon for the mass number A around 20. So this is around 28 MeV. Thereafter the rise of curve is much slower, reaching a maximum of 8.7 MeV per nucleon for iron. This is the iron for maximum nearly 8.7 MeV. If A is increased still further, the curve decreases slowly. This is when A is increasing, the curve is decreasing. Now the second conclusion is the variation of FB is very slight in the mass number range 20 to 180. So this is around 20 and this is 180. So this is nearly constant, and in the region FB may be considered to be virtually constant with a mean value 8.5 MeV per nucleon. This is around 8.5. This is 8, this is 9, so it is in between. Now the third conclusion is for A greater than 180, that is for heavy nuclei, FB value decreases monotonically with increasing A. This is for greater than 180. Mass number is greater than 180, this is monotonically decreasing. So decreases monotonically with increasing A. and it is around 7.5 MeV per nucleon for the heaviest nuclei. So this is the heaviest nuclei and this is around 7.5 MeV. This is clear. For heavy nuclei, the binding energy per nucleon is around 7.5 MeV for the heaviest nuclei. So fourth is, the rapid fluctuation in Fb is noted for the very light nuclei with peaks in the curve in this region corresponding to even nuclei, that is for helium, barium, carbon and oxygen. This is helium, oxygen, carbon, that is for mass number A equal to 4n, where n is 1 into 3 dot dot dot. Also seen at z are n equal to 20, 28, 50, 82 and 186. These are called the magic number. तो ऐसा भी देखते हैं कि जहाँ प्रोटॉन नंबर 28, 50, 82 या 126 है, वहाँ भी बाइंडिंग एनर्जी कर्व हाई है, बिकॉज दिस आर द मैजिक नंबर विच इज़ मोर स्टेबल दैन द अदर. नाउ मास डिफेक्ट. सो मास डिफेक्ट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एटॉमिक मास एंड द मास नंबर ऑफ द न्यूक्लियस एंड कैन बी रिटन एज डेल्टा एम डैश इक्वल मास ऑफ एटम माइनस मास नंबर. फॉर ऑक्सीजन इट इज दिस. नाउ द पैकिंग फ्रैक्शन एफ इज डिफाइंड एज द मास डिफेक्ट पर न्यूक्लियन इन द न्यूक्लियस. सो वी कैन राइट एज एफ इक्वल टू डेल्टा एम डैश अपॉन ए विच इज इक्वल टू दिस. एंड फाइनली आफ्टर रीअरेंजिंग वी गेट दिस एक्सप्रेशन. Now the nuclear size, from experimental result we can say that the mass density of nucleus is almost remain constant as we shown in the experimental curve. So we can write as the rho m equal to a upon v, that is equal constant. So v proportional to a and v is nothing but the 4 by 3 pi r cube. क्योंकि हम nucleus को as a sphere suppose करते हैं, उसका volume 4 by 3 pi r cube लिख सकते हैं. So this radius is proportional to a to the power 1 by 3 and this finally give this expression r is equal to r naught a to the power 1 by 3, where r naught is a proportionality constant and its value lie in the range between 1.1 to 1.5 into 10 power minus 15 meter, where r 0 is generally taken as 1.2 into 10 power minus 15 meter. So this is important. So must remember. So this is all about for today. So I hope this is clear to all of you. If anything confusing, you can comment. So thanks for watching video. Thank you.